All I ever wanted was to be great. Look good, winning like a sweet stays. Go check the stats, all we do is win. Gotta make it clear, this is a PSA. Make a drip, flex in front of TSA. From NY, we taking dubs in every state. I ain't gonna lie, we was broke, now we getting paid. It was hot, van, now you flying in no kind of planes. Blood, sweat, tears, we was putting in no kind of pain. F I never liked, now they giving us a type of break. Starting at the bottom, now we ending with a legacy. And but where you start, by how long it take to finish it. Winning, but it's more than a game. City taking village, make you more than a main. If you ain't hungry, you gon' get left. No one finna make you do more than you can. Finna get bucks, I be all in the pain. Can't stop, won't stop, destiny.
Appreciate you, my brother, coming through to the PSA podcast. Super proud of you. Just wanted to have you share your academic journey from middle school up to where you are now, which is the PSA alum to graduate college the fastest to obtain your college degree in 3 years, master's approaching in that fourth year.
It was hard starting out in middle school in Brooklyn, in Flatbush, at Walt Whitman, you know, trying to find my way, you know, not comfortable in the public school system. Everyone's not trying to be there. Kids not trying to be there. Teachers not trying to be there. And I just couldn't do it after a while. So for a minute, I just decided that I was just going to skip school, do things that wasn't the best for me in my situation at the time, but it's just mentally I just couldn't put myself in those situations. So I started to do that, trying to find ways to just get myself out of there. And it set me back to about two or three grades, and I had to figure it out. And then I had to moved on to high school. But how did I get to the high school situation? I worked out in a showcase in Riverbank, where Showcase had high school coaches, and I'm playing, going up and down, and all the coaches started to come over to my side, started to talk to me, all of the high school coaches. But none of you guys actually knew about me failing at that time, because I kept it a secret. I didn't want nobody to, you know, look down upon me and everything. But it was best that I played in a tournament called Fun Sport, mm-hmm. where I was close with a lady. I'm still close with her. My lady, Coach Ricky, Miss Ricky. She had spoke to Ricky Rivers, which was the owner, the director of Fun Sport.
Shout out to Ricky Rivers.
He spoke to Ricky Rivers, and he literally told you guys, like, listen, he can't play in this tournament no more if he don't get his grades together. And that's when you guys actually found out about my situation, and we tried to find the best possible situation at that time for me to go to as fast as you could. And then I went to Hoosac, and I ran into a great guy in Michael Foster, and he took a chance on me and skipped me from sixth grade to eighth, which was like a shell shock for me, because I was at a sixth grade level in eighth grade. And in prep school, you can be in eighth grade taking classes with 10th, 11th graders. So it was just definitely not the ideal situation, but it was at the same time. So it took me a while to get adjusted. Took me a while to get adjusted to it. But, you know, I eventually did.
It's called the male adjustment.
I moved on to McDuffie School for a year, which the academics there were pretty hard. But, you know, I figured it out.
No adjustment.
And I moved back to Hoosac for my last year to finish up with a 3.8. So, you know, it was a tough road at the beginning, but I eventually started to figure things out. And then I was able to move on to college.
So what were some of those, the techniques that you used to help you in terms of, like, your progression at Hoosac, as far as, like, increasing your reading level, increasing your comprehension level, being able to handle more and more, like, greater amounts of reading as you went through? Like, what was some of
those? That's literally the biggest thing, was my reading comprehension at that time. I was at a sixth grade level, so it was just pretty much trying to figure out what's the best way to help me comprehend and be able to read at that level at that time. And study halls was a big deal at that time for me. They put the work in with me. I salute to Hoosac School for this. They put in the work put in all the work they possibly can. Late nights, middle of the day, during sports hours, just trying to put in the most work they possibly can to catch me up. And I started to get on and, you know, figure it out, and pretty much started to, you know, shape my future.
in high school, you got tested for an IEP. Can you explain what that is?
Yeah, so in my freshman year, when I went into Hackensack, I got tested for IEP. It's just pretty much just helping students out with their academics, trying to figure out what their weaknesses and strengths are, and just seeing what extra help they can possibly give to you. So I went out to Philly and did that when I was a freshman and got that done. And it pretty much helped me to get all the help I can possibly need moving forward.
When you graduated from high school, what was that feeling?
Oh man, I was in awe. Like I didn't ever in a million years can ever possibly think I can even graduate high school, to let alone get to college. So it was just a big deal. For one, at one point I didn't think I was gonna get past middle school because I just didn't want to do it.
Yeah.
So for me to even get a high school diploma, it was just a big deal to see my mother sitting there in the crowd, proud of me. You know, I shed some tears on that. So it was just a really big deal and a special day for me.
So now take me through your first year at UMass. What was that like?
Stepping on campus, first like week or two, I was just in awe. I was just happy to be there. I was just smiling from, you know, ear to ear, just because this is just a different environment. And, you know, everybody's excited to play, you know, get on the court, meet the guys, in the new facilities and different things like that. So I was just so happy. But, you know, it wasn't in the works for me to, you know, things happened, started injuries and different things like that. So I redshirted my freshman year, which helped me get ahead for even thinking of graduating in 3 years. You know, it helped me get ahead in academics and get settled in.
Right. And what was that inspiration when you, what was the light bulb that was like, yo, you could graduate in 3 years? Was that something that you wanted to do?
I was watching some video. I forgot what video it was, but I seen that Kemba Walker did it in three.
Yeah.
So when I seen it, I was just like, whoa, like you can do that? So I've always been like, listen, I didn't even think I would get through high school. So I've already exceeded my expectations with getting a 3.8 for my senior year. Let's try to do something better. So it was just literally just trying to see if I could possibly even do it in 3 years. And I did it.
And what's the process that a person would have to go through to graduate early?
That process is pretty much taking the best classes for you and not switching your majors. I think when you get your major and you show on that, stick with it, because that helps to either graduate early or, you know, graduate on time. And I think when students start to switch around and trying to figure it out and switching, it delays it. So I think when I figured out what I wanted to do, which was communications at that time, because it fits me, I love it, that's what I decided to stick with, and it worked.
And so what are some of the advantages of being able to graduate early?
Advantages? Yeah, I'm about to get my master's in probably four. So the advantages is getting it over with. That's the advantage. It felt like it was going to take forever, but the advantage is be able to move on faster in life and feel accomplished. You know, that type of work and getting that work off your back, it was just definitely just an accomplishment that I felt like anything that's moving forward I can possibly get through, because I've seen the worst.
Yeah. Was it difficult to adjust going from high school to college?
At first it was, but seeing that I took that year off from basketball, I was able to get adjusted as the same way I was when I went to Hackensack. It's just a lot of study halls and a lot of time of studying on your own and breaking everything down to the T to make sure you get everything.
Yeah. And so now you're at St. Francis.
Mm-hmm.
What is your focus in your master's right now?
My focus in master's is business management. I thought mixing that with a communications degree, because communications is so broad, you know, you can get so many jobs off of communications. I thought business degree would, you know, just help that a little bit more.
What do you see in your future after acquiring this master's degree?
I mean, obviously the ultimate goal is always to try to play pro somewhere.
Yep.
But after the basketball stops, it's just trying to find the best fit for me. And people don't know this, but I always wanted to go back to school and get my social worker degree, you know, to help others that was in my position that just doesn't have no hope of getting through the situation that they're in. So I've always wanted to do that, do some public speaking, just different little small things that's on my mind as of right now.
your destiny.